Hello guys, I welcome you all to my channel. Now this is the first exercise. We will learn and use different features and commands in this exercise, and we will use the previously learned commands and features. So we will model this design. You can see here. So let's start this. First of all, we need a plane. Now in the picture here, you can see this model is not fully created in single plane. We will need different planes in which we need to draw different sketches. So first of all, we will work with top plane and we will draw our base on the top plane. You can see here. So select top plane. Create. Now I will select center line. Select. Now make this midpoint coincident with the origin. Okay. Now make this length equals to 56 millimeter or inches in whatever dimension you are working with. Make it 56. Okay. Now you can see the outer circle have 18 millimeter radius and the inner circle has 16 inches dia. So we will draw two circles. Now make it 18 multiplied by 2 and make this one 16. Select. Now make this circle and this circle equal. Similarly, make these two circles equal. Okay. Now draw a line tangent to both these circles and chain. Okay. Now use trim entities command and trim this portion. Okay, now our base sketch is ready. And we need to extrude it 8 mm. So extrude it. Give this dimension 8 mm. Keep it blind. Accept. Okay. So our base is ready now. So now we need to make this 32 mm portion at the back. Okay. So we will select this face and select sketch. Now this face will serve as a sketching plane. Now select a corner rectangle. Make it normal. Now draw a corner rectangle. Okay. Now draw a center line like this. Okay. Now select these two points and this line and make it symmetric. Here you can see our rectangle is changing its dimension symmetrically along the center line. Now you can see the dimension is 40 mm and thickness is 10 mm and extrusion is 32 mm. So give it dimensions 10 40 accept. Now go to features and extrude it, make it 32 accept. Okay, now we will create this portion. Now here we will use a new command, which is rip command here. So we will now draw a sketch on right plane. Sorry, select right plane. Make it normal. It's okay now. So draw a line. Make sure the line is coincident with these edges. Okay, now go to features and select rib. Now you can see the features applied outward. We need to flip the material side. So check this box. Now it is inward. Here there are three options. You can make this feature on the one side of the line like this, or the other side, or you can make this feature in both sides. This dimension now 10 mm will be divided 5 mm on the one side and 5 mm on the other side. So here you can also give the angle, but we don't need it, so we will just accept as it is. Accept it. So it is created now. So now we need to make the circle and this upper part. Now we will draw our sketch on this plane. Sketch. Make it normal. Now draw two lines, but don't make it vertical. You can see the vertical sign. Okay, you need to tilt it a little bit. Similarly, draw another line here. Don't make it vertical also. Accept it. Now draw a center line. Make it coincident with the midpoint. Now give it dimension 32 mm. 32 mm or was it? Yes, it was 32 mm. Okay, give it 32 mm dimension. Accept. Now we need to make two circles, 30 mm and 20 mm diameter. So now draw two circles. Now give it dimension. Make it 30. And make it 20. Now you can see these lines are black, but these two lines are blue. This is because these black lines means the sketch is fully defined, but these blue lines means the sketch is underdefined. So we will make those circle and line tangent. Similarly, with this line, make it tangent. And you can see the point is still not defined. So make this point and this circle coincident. Similarly here, make it coincident. Sorry, I have to make it coincident. Accept. Now go to features, go to extrude. Now here it is asking about the contours, because we have more than one closed regions. So we will select this one and this one only for now. Make it reverse and make the dimension 10. Okay. Accept. Also check this box, merge result. It will merge this solid and this solid part. Accepted. Now go to this drop down, go to the sketch and make it show. Okay, select this plane sketch and select these two circles and go to convert entities. Okay, now go to features. Here select this button and select mid plane and make it 20. As you can see, this circle is 10 mm above and 10 mm below this face. And also check this merge result box, accept and hide it. Now remember, there are different easy ways also to model this part, but I tried to use as much features and commands as I could. So in order to make you learn different features and commands. Okay, we will now give this part some color. Here go to edit appearance. Here you can see different options like select part, select faces, surfaces and bodies. So we will select bodies and we will select this body. Sorry, select this. Now you can select this body. Now you can choose different color here. Okay, now accept. Now our part is ready. So if you find this video informative, then you subscribe the channel.